If you're watching this video, that means you already know Pinterest can be a hugely important marketing tool as a creator. The more people who see your content, engage with it, and better yet, click through your pins to visit your website or storefront, the more income you can make. So how can we create engaging Pinterest content that garners saves, repins, and click-throughs so that you can get your name out there and grow your brand? Well, let's get into it. I have been on Pinterest for over 10 years, and because of Pinterest, I've been able to do things like increase my overall blog traffic and earn more money from ad revenue, build my email list by marketing my freebie, the Influencer Launchpad, over on Pinterest, and even sell more digital products because of pins I've created spreading the word. When it comes to creating pins, there is no easier tool in the world to use than Canva. So today I'm going to share my screen, take you inside of my Canva profile, and teach you how to create engaging pins.
Okay, so here we are in Canva, one of my favorite places to be on my computer, and I'm going to show you how I find and design pin types to content, to help me get email signups, to promote digital products, and so much more. So designing pins in Canva is super easy because you can either start from scratch, you can look for a blank template here with Pinterest dimensions if you want to, or you can actually search through all of Canva's different templates. So let's go ahead and do a quick search for Pinterest pin templates and see what comes up. So once you're in Canva, you have all of these different options for pin templates. I highly recommend this, especially if you are not super graphic design savvy. I personally am not. That's why I love Canva templates. And you'll also notice that some templates here have this little crown emoji. That means that those are Canva Pro templates. So I have a Canva Pro account and I love it because you just get so much more capability and access within Canva. You can use so many more templates. There are so many more stock photo options and graphics options. So I have a link to a 30-day free trial of Canva Pro. If you're thinking about maybe signing up for it, definitely check out the free trial first. But for purposes of this video, I will stick to as many materials and free graphics as possible. But you can even see just from a quick scroll here how some of these, you know, might look more your vibe than others. You might want something more bold and graphic like this, or you might want something a little more laid back and neutral. So take a scroll through and see which of these kind of stand out to you the most. And you can also kind of use these as a jumping off point to create some of your own templates as well. So once you've gone through and maybe starred or favorited some of the templates that you think you might want to use, what I would suggest is creating a new project in Canva. I am using the size 1080 by 1500 pixels here just because I feel like that is kind of standard Pinterest size. You might want to make them a little bit more vertical, or I don't really recommend square, but because vertical typically performs best on Pinterest. So you can adjust this based on what's best for you, but these are the dimensions I typically use for my Pinterest pins. And you can call it, you know, pins to promote content. You can call it my Pinterest pins, whatever you want to name this Canva file. And then you can have pages with all of your different pin templates here. So when you go to create pins later to promote a new blog post or to link to a TikTok video, whatever it might be, you already have this kind of template here to work off of. Now, I went ahead and just did something very basic here. I thought I would show you how to create three different pin types. The first one I'm going to show you is how you can create a pin to promote a new blog post, YouTube video, whatever piece of content you want to promote. So what I've done here is I've made these three separate text boxes that spell out the title of a blog post that I've written. So your guide to affiliate income as a creator. And of course, I have my website here down below. I mean, I could just pin this if I really wanted to, but there are very easy ways to kind of jazz these things up. So I'm going to show you how to do that. And we can do this really just by using some simple Canva elements. So the first thing that I want to do is add one of my custom gradients to this. So if I type in gradient here, you'll see some of these custom gradients that I've created that are my brand colors, if you notice. So this is my light pink, this is my salmon, but then it has a little bit of a fade to it. I love using these in my marketing materials. So if I click on that, it'll appear here on the pin. I'm going to use the rotation feature to rotate it to 90 degrees. And for position, I would click to back, but it is already in the back because Canva has realized that I probably want that to be the background. Now, you might be wondering, I just added this background, but how did I get this white border underneath the text? And this is actually a Canva hack that I only learned, I think, within the last few months, because before what I would do is I would add a shape like this rectangle. You know, it would be this color and I would drag it and try to center it. And then I would try to add the text over it to make sure that the text was centered. So I would go into brand fonts and do this and drag it up and change the color and all this stuff and try to make it the right size. But then what if you want to change the text that you wrote? What if instead of your guide to affiliate income, I wanted to say the ultimate guide? If I were to do that up here, the ultimate guide, see how it's not adjusting together? So that is what this Canva hack helps with. So for any text that you add here, you can go to effects on Canva, and then down here, you're gonna pick background. And when you pick background, you can also adjust the roundness, right? So if I wanted to round this and make it a more circular shape, I could do that. If I wanted to make it more transparent, change the color, all of these different things you can do with the text effect. So I highly recommend that because if I were to delete it, it goes away and it perfectly writes out and gives the right spacing to the rest of your text. So highly recommend trying that if you have not yet in Canva. But then to keep things simple here, what I might do is add in this rectangle again. I'm gonna bring it forward and I have it right now as my salmon color from my brand kit. This is also a Canva Pro feature to be able to add in your brand kit, your brand colors. So that's super helpful and speeds up the design process as well. So maybe I'll take this salmon color and put it down underneath this font. Maybe I'll change that to white just so it pops a little bit more. And maybe I actually want to add another line kind of down here. So I just duplicated that rectangle, making this line. And maybe to make this really pop, I want this to be one of my other brand colors just to show that separation. You could make this text bigger. I definitely recommend making your blog domain name, if you're promoting back to a blog post, very visible, or adding your social media handle, whatever that looks like to you for whatever content you're promoting. And so here we go. We have transformed just text on a plain background into a very cute and eye-catching pin utilizing my brand colors. It's very clear what you're gonna get when you click on this pin, and that was a super easy way to do so. Now let's talk about how to create a pin to get more signups for your email newsletter. So my email newsletter freebie is a free guide called The Influencer Launchpad. And right now, all I've got here on the screen is that text, the Influencer Launchpad, and this little button down here that says download. Again, I'm using that text effects thing, as you can see, and I've actually rounded out the edges so it looks a little bit more like a button. I feel like that's a good visual cue for people to have them actually click through a pin. So one of my favorite things within Canva is that they have frames where you can take all of these different frames and use them to drag a photo into, and it will appear as though it's in the frame. And one of my favorite frames on Canva is this frame that looks just like a phone. So what I usually like to do is change the background of the phone to be white because I feel like that's just more visually on my brand. You could change it to be any color that you want though. That's one of the great things about how customizable this all is. And for that reason, for now, let's make the background one of my other colors. Might change this in a moment. I'm kind of really just taking you through my exact process here of the experimentation and how I try to decide what the final design is going to look like. So when I go over to my uploads here, I have gone ahead and taken a screenshot of what it looks like on your mobile phone when you click into my freebie. So of course I have this screenshot and I could just have this screenshot on the screen, but because I've got this frame here, all I have to do is drag it into the frame. And now you can see exactly what that landing page looks like that people click on if they decide to opt into my email newsletter to get their free guide. Now, like I just said, we're adjusting as we go here. So normally I would have this phone background as white, but I'm actually going to do, I think, a light gray, because see how the sides of my website are white and it was making the phone not as prominent and not really stand out as much. Could also try a color. I just think that is a lot going on there, so I think the light gray is probably the move. And another thing about Canva is even though you, for Canva Pro, can add your exact brand colors and you can see the exact hex value when I hover over it, you can also take this and drag the color to make it a little bit more saturated or a little bit less saturated than your actual color if you think it will help a design. So as long as it's close enough to your brand colors and your pins still look somewhat cohesive, I think that's totally normal. And then I'm going to try making this text this bright red because I think that is more punchy. And now it's just a matter of continuing to play with the design here. I love the guides on Canva, so you can see the spacing for each thing. You can see how far apart everything is. Gonna maybe make the download button a little bit bigger or say download now. And there you go. So it has this call to action here to download. It's called the Influencer Launchpad. That alone should probably catch someone's eye and make them think, oh, what is that? And you can see the actual guide image here, but it's in this cute phone background. Okay, and now let me show you how I create pins that help promote my digital products. So again, I love the frames. So I've taken this iPad frame and then just a regular rectangular frame to kind of layer behind it. And I've given them this very light pink border. Same thing, I kind of took one of my brand colors and toned down the saturation because I thought it was a little too aggressive, the pink and the blue right next to each other. And what I'm able to do is, again, take the cover page for one of my digital products. This is my brand campaign wrap-up report, and simply drag it into the frame there and then drag one of the pages to the frame behind it. And I like this because it doesn't give away exactly what is inside the digital product. It kind of just shows a hint of what one of the pages looks like, but of course I'm happy to share the cover there. And then I can really take this and do a lot of different things with it. If I wanted to add a little bit of a pop here, I could also add another rectangle down here, maybe change these font colors and stuff, or I could just leave it as is. Another thing that I like to do sometimes is add a little arrow, so you can scroll through different arrows and see which ones you might like. So I can rotate it like this, drag it down over here, make it a little bit smaller. And then I can also go ahead and change the color to make it white, or I could make it, you know, red, I could make it pink, I could make it all different colors, but I think white kind of tends to look best with this blue color. And maybe I want to spotlight the text here that says edit in Canva. So maybe again, I'll go to effects and give it a little bit of a background, but maybe I will make it that regular pink color and bold the text so it's easier to read. I think that calling out one of the features of the digital product, like the fact that you can edit it in Canva, would make someone more inclined to potentially click on it. And of course, I've got my website down here. I'm gonna make that a little bit bigger and again, make it bold so that it's easier to see, especially if someone's scrolling through Pinterest on their mobile device. It's not always as easy to catch all of these little details. So we wanna make it as legible and as easy for people to read as possible. So I was basically using that other file to demo to you how I create these pins, but I did wanna scroll through kind of my main pin file that I have here. I have them called digital product pin templates, but they can also be used for blog posts and things like that. So I just wanted to share, once you have a pin design down that you really like, I think that making multiple versions of it is the easiest way to get more and more Pinterest content that you can then go out and schedule. That's always constantly there, constantly searchable, so that people can find your content on an evergreen funnel, essentially. So maybe this one was your guide to affiliate income as a creator. All I did here, as you can see, is change up the colors and change up what I'm saying. So if your guide to affiliate income maybe didn't catch someone's attention, what about how to make money with affiliates as an influencer? So thinking about these keywords and just seeing which ones might catch someone's eye. Maybe someone's more drawn to blue also than they are to pink. So making multiple versions of these things is really key. Even for this one, how to wrap up your brand campaigns like a pro, how to impress brands at the end of a campaign. It's the same design. We just changed and swapped through the colors in my brand kit to still make them consistent, still make them look like my brand and my pins, but to give them a little bit of a different look. Same thing here, SEO for creators, SEO for bloggers. If you don't identify with the term creator, maybe you identify with the term blogger. So you get the idea here. Once you have a design you like, I recommend recreating it in a few different iterations, maybe trying some different fonts, trying some different colors, and then going into your Pinterest analytics to see what's performing best.
Don't forget to grab your 30-day free trial of Canva Pro from the link down below in the description box to level up your pin creation and speed up your process. If you enjoyed today's video, please subscribe for more videos just like this one. I put out new videos every single week on my channel. And if you'd like to learn more about how to monetize your Pinterest account, be sure to check out the up next recommendation on the screen. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.